Chen Guang is a salesman at Xinshi Model Shop in downtown Beijing. It's the ideal place for army fans to pick out their favorites, the latest military models in all sizes and shapes from all around the globe. The 38-year-old salesman says more and more customers come to his shop and buy models of the Chinese People's Liberation Army. Of all the toys on offer, Chen told us China's Liaoning aircraft carrier has become one of the most popular.
包括电子设备也好啊，包括舰载设备也好，很多都属于国产化。
The Liaoning was China's first aircraft carrier commissioned into the PLA Navy on September 25, 2012. The 304-meter-long carrier has been an iconic image of the country's burgeoning military prowess.
那么再引进了一些新型的装备，那么我们看，新一代的驱逐舰、护卫舰和潜艇以及导弹快艇相继如列，我们这个航母。
Zhang Junshe, senior researcher at the Navy's Military Studies Research Institute, says Chinese naval forces have been greatly improved over the past 60 years. Thanks to these improvements, China now has the ability to implement defensive measures more quickly and effectively. In 2013, Beijing publicly declared the establishment of the East China Sea Air Defense Identification Zone, or ADIZ. As a result, all aircraft entering the area are obliged to report to the Chinese authorities and follow their instructions.
中国这次设立防空识别区，它主要目的是为了维护国家领土领空的安全，那么为我们国土防空提供这个有效的预警时间和预警这个。
More than 20 nations have set up their own ADIZs, and several of them are more than half a century old.
这个美国、日本等一些国家，在50年代、60年代都早已经设立了防空识别区。我觉得对中国作为一个大国。
From the first aircraft carrier to the establishment of the ADIZ, any improvement of China's defense was a headline story overseas, even triggering the so-called China threat talk. But Professor Gong Fangbin thinks it's natural for China to be under a close watch when the country grows up.
这叫成长的烦恼。成长烦恼是什么？你弱小的时候，很多的矛盾都存在，南海的问题、东海的问题、黄海的问题。我们希望能够维持地区和平稳定，我们也做出了很大的努力，但是这个不在我们这个最后的这个结果不在我们中国一方。现在，应该说，有关方面、有关的国家应该像中国一样，也采取。
克制的态度。那为什么一段时间有时候平静呢？因为你力量小的时候，你保护不了，保护不了就放下，就平静了，显得平静。但今天我们有力量来维护我们权利的时候，它就出现了碰撞。On
March 5th, the Chinese government announced the fastest yearly growth in the country's defense budget in 3 years. China plans to raise its defense budget by 12.2% to 808.2 billion yuan. About $132 billion in 2014. The budget has triggered different reactions. Shortly after the announcement, Japan accused China of lacking transparency in its defense expenditure. But China hit back, saying the Chinese People's Liberation Army was not Boy Scouts with spears.
即使是童子军，它的个头也是一年比一年长。
你总不能让他总是穿着以前的小衣服小鞋吧。
According to Chen Zhou, a researcher with the Academy of Military Sciences and a national lawmaker, China's uniform and shoes are not big enough at all. He says the country's defense budget is still dwarfed by that of other major world powers, both in terms of its share in GDP and per capita. He says that the share of national defense spending in China's GDP stood at less than 1.5% last year, well below the world average of 3%. Echoing Chen, Gong says the growth rate of military spending is relatively fast, whereas the amount is relatively small. As China's economic and military powers are growing, so are its due responsibilities in the world. One example is China's unprecedented naval deployment in the Gulf of Aden and Somali waters. Chinese warships have been escorting merchant vessels to protect them from piracy since the end of 2008.
那么另外一个方面还有中国军队派出这个维和部队在世界各地来执行维和应该说中国在五个联合国常任理事国中是派出维和部队数量最多的一个国家已经在二十多个点上进行这个执勤这是这一些吧就足够足以说明中国军队这个力量的增长对于世界的和平稳定是一个正能量
On March 5th, Premier Li Keqiang delivered a government work report at the second session of the 12th National People's Congress in Beijing. In the report, he said China will carry out coordinated planning for military preparedness in all scenarios and areas. Experts have given their advice and interpretations of the future of China's armed forces.
所以我们得研提高我们两洋作战能力，就是要维护我们在太平洋和印度洋。两个大洋上的海上交通线的这个安全那么从长远看中国海军还应该具备全球这个活动能力
As China grows stronger some members of the international community argue a strong China will pursue hegemony fabricating a China threat but experts suggest the international community adopt constructive dialogue and an open attitude to cope with China's rise
所以我想这件事要这样来看待，不怕事，不挑事也不怕事。
所以我们不挑事，这是我们一个重要的一个外交上处理原则，也是我们军事斗争的原则。但是不怕事呢，他如果挑战我们，那对不起，我中国人民解放军的军事力量就会出动。
冷战就是互相强化的结果，我们不能冷战思维把中国推成敌人呐。中国毕竟在谁也挡不住的节奏的前进，所以我说世界都在。静静地考虑一下我们国际关系大国关系怎么处理怎么看中国怎么理解中国的崛起
我们战略上不打第一枪但是我们绝对不允许对手打第二枪第二枪一定是我打
This is CNC World A New Perspective